Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Mitesh Khatri. I'm a leadership trainer, motivational speaker, and a best-selling author of Awaken the Leader in You. Today's Monday, so we're going to talk about a very important leadership lesson in English, as you know. And what is today's lesson? It's about perception management. Exactly, perception management. What is perception management? Perceived reality is more important than even actual reality, because that's the power of perceptions. Perceived reality is more powerful than even actual reality. Let me give you an example of that. When you buy a product, 90% of the reasons why you buy the product is because of the perception, is not because of the experience of the product. There are two realities in the world: perceived reality, and then there is experience reality. Okay? Perceived reality and experience reality. Now, what is perceived reality? When you buy a product because you see it on TV, have you experienced it already? No, but you've already made the decision of buying it. Why? Because of the perception that this is a great product. So 90% of our decisions are based on perceptions, not even reality. After you buy the product, you've experienced it. So then you've got into something called as experience reality, right? Now, if once you experience the product, it has to match your perceptions. It has to match your perceptions. If it matches your perceptions, you're going to become a fan of that product and you'll keep buying, keep buying, keep buying. And then what happens is you spread the perception because of the experience reality match the perception. You spread that perception to other people, and more customers buy that product because of the perceived reality that you are forwarding to other people. So then you become a brand ambassador for the product. Now, similarly, you as a leader are a product in yourself. When you talk to people, you have a certain perception in the crowd. You have a certain perception in your team. You have a certain perception with your boss. You have a certain perception with your wife. You have a certain perception with your family members. And do you know that no matter who you are as a real person, it really doesn't matter. Who you are as a real person is a secondary matter. The primary matter is people will treat you based on what they perceive you as, right? So for an example, let us say that your friend perceives you as a very selfish person, and you believe that in actuality, in reality, you're not a selfish person at all. You strongly believe about yourself that you're a very selfless person. But if your friend believes that you're a selfish person, that perception is going to dominate how that friend treats you. Make sense? So what do you need to do as a leader? As a leader, you need to constantly work on your perceptions. And then create a high perceived reality in the market for yourself. Create a high perceived reality in your team, in your family. And then match that perception with that experience. Let me give you an example of what I'm trying to say here. Let us say you buy a product because a friend told, or forget about a product. Let's say a friend tells you that you got to watch this movie. It's an amazing movie. Now you make that decision of watching that movie only based on that perception. You probably spend 1500, 2000 rupees, go to PVR, have a popcorn, take your family with you for the movie. And when you come back, your experience reality tell you it was a not so good movie, it was not worth an investment. Now what happened? The perceived reality went up, but the experience reality was down. So because of that, you didn't like the movie. Now what's going to happen is you're going to create a negative perception about that movie now amongst other people. You're going to go to Make My Trip, you're going to put negative reviews over there. And because of your reviews, that perception, which is a negative perception for other people, is not going to spread. And based on those perceptions, people are not going to watch that movie in future, right? So that's the kind of power that has in the market on social media right now because of the perception management. So now people have to be really careful that not only do you create a high perception, but you need to match that with experience reality. So don't just go around talking about great about yourself, but also make sure that you're doing what is necessary to match that perception with people. So for an example, you want your family to perceive you as a very, very supportive person. So you can talk about it, of course. Make sure that you talk about it, but then make sure that you show it in your actions. Because if you don't show it in your actions, it's not going to match your perception reality with your experience reality. And then you're going to fail. And then the perception is going to further drop. And then it's going to drop below the actual reality. And that's going to really trouble you. Same thing in the office. As a leader, it's your responsibility that in front of your team members, in front of your friends, in front of your bosses, you need to make sure that you manage your perception, right? If your boss is giving you negative feedback, and if you're suddenly fighting with the boss, the perception that you're creating is you're not open to feedback. In reality, you may be open to feedback, but in that moment when you argue with the boss, you've created a perception that you're not open to feedback. And maybe it was in the spur of the moment that you reacted, but it doesn't matter. That one moment and that spur of the moment reaction, if that creates a perception in somebody's mind that you are not open to feedback, they will carry that perception for a long time in the future, and it'll take you a lot of time to change that perception. Right? So today's leadership lesson is very, very important. Please ask yourself this question. What is the perception I carry in my team members? What is the perception I carry in my market? What is the perception I carry in front of my boss, in my family? Ask yourself that question. Write down the answer. What are the perceptions that you have around you? And then write down, what is the perception you want them to have? Okay, what is the perception you want them to have? Now work on taking action so that you can create such experience reality for people that their perception about you changes, okay? Their perception about you changes. Then you're really managing your leadership, because simply doing great job as a leader in the office is not gonna get you a promotion. It's not gonna get you growth and success. You're not gonna get love and connection from everyone and importance from everyone simply because you're a great human being. You have to let people know you're a great human being. You have to talk for yourself. And if you won't, others won't, okay? So ask yourself that question. What is my perception? Write it down. What's the perception I want to have? Write that down, and then work towards that perception by giving people that experience. Once people have that experience and it's fit in their mind that that's the kind of person you are, that perception of theirs because of that experience reality remains in the long term. Now, once in a while after that, if you go against that perception once in a while, it doesn't matter, because now the positive perception is working for you. For an example, it's fit into your boss's mind that you are extremely open to feedback. Now you're in a bad mood and you said something wrong and you got into a reactive state of mind and you ended up getting short-tempered with your boss. Now, because you have a great positive perception with your boss that you're very open to feedback, your boss is going to understand that this is a one-off case, right? But only because you consciously created that perception for the last few days or few months that you're open to feedback, that will work in your favor. Make sense? Okay, great. So I hope that makes sense. Forward this video to people who you think need perception management understanding. And if you've liked the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to watch more of these videos and you want to be intimate, if you want to get information about them, just subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done that, so that every Monday and Friday, I'll keep in touch with you. Okay. See you next Friday. We'll be talking in Hindi on the law of attraction. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.